Hey, it's Dr. Amanda with Street Smile Solutions, streetsmilesolutions.com, and today we're going to talk about Invisalign's new CBCT integration into ClinCheck 6.0. And actually, I think it released a while ago, earlier this year, but they're really starting to promote it more now. I would really love it if they did some webinars and some other stuff. There's like so little education around this. I mean, I've asked for more information. They give you like a PDF handout, which is like super confusing, to be honest. So I'm going to try to translate it for you. I've kind of been reading it and I've been talking to a lot of doctors that are doing it. A lot of the doctors who are working with us at Street Smile Solutions are doing it. And I definitely see some reasons I would consider. I think that GPs should do it. I don't know as an orthodontist that I routinely do this. I mean, to be honest, I do take Cephs. So, you know, when we do cases, and especially if it's a case where we're considering AP changes or vertical changes, and we want to, you know, take a look at it and see where the incisors are relative to the cranial base, relative to the denture bases, can we distalize, can we not, how will the profile look? So I'm already doing that, so I have all the information I need. The bad part about this CBCT integration, it's nice because basically I think it's going to be good for general dentists in that they don't have that understanding or that fundamental understanding that an orthodontist would have about a Ceph. I can look at a Ceph. I don't even need numbers. I can look at a Ceph and I know exactly what I need to do and how I can make this ClinCheck awesome. I don't need to plunk it into this machine to have it look pretty, okay? I think it's great for educating patients though, because that's really hard to explain. That's always been an issue. Like, hey, I'm looking at this Ceph and I see this, so that's why we have to do the Invisalign this way. And they're like, huh? You know, and there's no way you're gonna be able to explain it to them fully. They just have to take your word. So by plunking this CBCT in it, then it's like, oh, I see that there's a dehiscence when I flare the incisors, you know? Like, it's really obvious that we ran out of bone. So for that reason, for patient education reason, or for general dentists who maybe don't understand it, I think it's gonna help because you can visualize it and it makes more sense from a dental point of view, okay? So that's why I think it's good. Will I use it? Probably not really. We have one case we're gonna maybe do it on in my husband's office. It's impacted canine case, and I think this, oh man, it's a nightmare. Really, really interdisciplinary case, and it would be really, really great for him to be able to see that. So I see it, but he doesn't understand it. So yeah, so these are the steps. Step one, when submitting a case, you have to click on Scans and Impressions and click the CBCT tab. So when you are clicking the case through, you're gonna see it at the bottom of that page, and that's where you're gonna upload it, right? There's a few notes here. And we don't own a CBCT yet, and we outsource for a CBCT, so I probably don't understand this stuff as well as you guys do who have it. But it does say it needs to be in the DICOM format. It has to be a single large DICOM file with all layers, or it can be a list of small DICOM files. So slices, it can be a lot of slices, or it can be one big one. So I know it's gonna be a slow upload for sure, and we're gonna do a little more content over it shortly. But yeah, so you just have to select it. The one thing I did notice is when it does come back, the gums don't look good on it. Like, what looks really slick with the gums in the regular setup, you're not gonna have it. I don't know if you can toggle back and forth. That would be nice. I haven't figured it out yet. It just looks, you can't really see the gum, so it looks weird. But I bet there's a way to do that. The other thing that's really important for those of you who are doing like molus or galor or have started been selecting the whole traditional RX versus, there's traditional RX and then there's, oh, what's it called? There's two different options and I'm blanking out. Traditional is the one you want. That's the main one. The new one, which is like computerized and I can't remember what they're calling it. They're calling it something else, but that's one you don't want. You want to make sure you're picking traditional, and you always want to pick traditional anyways, because traditional means a human looks at it and not a computer. So do what you're already doing, what I'm already telling you to do, which is click traditional when you submit it through. But yeah, you can't do the fast computerized. You can't be using your engines and doing this, I don't think, because the engines need the slick one. So yeah, I mean, that's pretty much it. And then you can now enable a roots button. Oh, so it sounds like there's a roots button in the toolbar that you can turn on and off. Oh, okay. So maybe you can turn it off. So next time I see one, I'm gonna play around with it and see. But they are saying that you do have to pick the ClinCheck Pro. You have to have that downloaded in order to do this. I saw that in this paperwork. However, the cases I've seen didn't all have ClinCheck Pro. So I don't know. I haven't figured that part out of it yet. But I mean, clearly, I feel like they kind of put the cart before the horse with this. They kind of like pushed it out super fast without educating people. And we're just kind of all clicking around and just winging it. And so far I've been relatively pleased. But yeah, just wanted to let you guys know it is here, and I think it definitely has a good functionality. It's definitely a start. All right, thanks.